All right, so I thought I'd show you really what happens early in the morning when I start doing Inspiration Wednesday, and it's not even that early. It's like 9:20, and I've been posting photos to Facebook and editing and emailing, and yeah, so this is me and my dogs. My dog likes to sit in the chair, as you can see. Hi, Tango. Tango likes to sit in the chair, which is kind of awkward because he's watching me as I'm working. Sometimes he gets down and walks in the camera, like, you know, and then Pixel, he just likes to be held. So look, he's in a happy place right here. That's when I'm not wearing my puppy purse and I just carry him around. So who knows? I might even do that as well. I kind of thought maybe I should record myself from the computer working on Inspiration Wednesday as well as the camera above. So let's just see. This is not pretty. This is unshowered and clearly just all kinds of nappy. So I have my painting shirt on. My painting pants on, and that's just how Inspiration Wednesday starts. Sometimes it takes me an hour, sometimes it takes me 3 hours, and then 2 hours to edit, whatever, that kind of stuff. So I guess I'm just going to leave this rolling, and maybe it'll be like after footage. I don't know. It's probably not going to be all that riveting, but yeah, you'll be able to see it. And I walk away, and you know, I've made coffee, because coffee is just vital for the Inspiration Wednesday process. So I'm just gonna go create. Hopefully it's quick, and we'll see what happens. All right, so Inspiration Wednesday. I'm actually recording this from the computer as well, so who knows what I'll do with this footage. I don't know. I might not even make the cut, but who knows. So I am working in the last few pages of this book, and it is really, really thick, but we're just gonna see what we can get from it. I've been kind of trying to tape the inside spine here, and grab my masking tape over here. Oh, it's a new roll. 1 second, please. So I've been kind of trying to tape inside here. Hopefully that holds the spine open a little bit better, but I don't really think it, you know, just crazy helping, but it does a little. And I'm just kind of taping this, and where the inclusion is, I'm just making sure that it's kind of ripped, that I can still turn the page. And I'm gonna do it on the other side. Oh, that was bad. Wonky tape pulling. Oh, still wonky tape. All right, so do it on the other side. I don't need to go from top to bottom. I just need to go kind of where that inclusion is. And do something like this. And that does two things. It does help the paint from seeping through the center of the book, but it also just helps to open up the page just a little bit more. And I'm just gonna get this. So I'm thinking I want to use glass bead gel today. And I don't think I've used glass bead gel. It's not very often in my journal, but I do love the stuff. So I don't think I even need to gesso this page. I mean, it's fairly white. There's no mess on it. So glass bead gel is basically the small glass beads in gel medium. And what that does is it adds this really cool texture. And then it does take a little while to dry. It takes, you know, like gel medium doesn't dry right away. And I'm gonna apply it with a palette knife. And I don't know if you can see the texture, you probably hear it. And I want it to be fairly thin, not so thin that it's not gonna leave texture, but thin enough that it's not gonna take forever to dry. And I'm gonna try to go end to end, but make it really uneven. So it's not like one layered coat. It's kind of this sketchy patchwork of glass bead gel. Now you could actually colorize this. I could take acrylic paint and colorize it and then put it on. But I find that if I colorize any of the mediums before I put them on my pages, I only get like one flat color. So I actually like to let it dry and then paint on top and have the glass beads underneath react to the transparency of the golden paint. Granted, there's probably times where colorizing it might be beneficial. I just haven't found it yet. So I'm just gonna continue to kind of coat. I've got all kinds of color coming off of my palette knife because I don't clean. There's gonna be areas of this that are gonna be the regular cardstock paper underneath because it's got a different absorbency and it's not gessoed, it should have a different reaction to the paint when I do that. I'm gonna go right over the inclusion too. Just cover everything today with this really texturized layer of glass bead gel. But I'll be honest with you, beyond taking out the glass bead gel and applying it with a palette knife, I don't have any expectation or plan for this page, so we're just gonna keep winging it. All right, so I've been sitting here drying this with a hair dryer on a really like cool setting, because the last thing I want is this gel medium to kind of bubble. And by bubble, I mean like if you heat it on a really high heat, it'll kind of cook from the inside and kind of do a Jiffy Pop thing. So it is dry to the touch, meaning I'm not getting anything on my hands. However, it is not purely dry. I should probably walk away from this and come back in 2 hours and let it air dry. It'll probably dry a little differently if I don't force dry it. But for today, for my purpose, the more texture, the more fabulous. And because it's got like a gel medium inside of there, gel medium is just clear acrylic paint, so I can layer stuff on top of it without really destroying anything. The one thing I want to do and talk about is that I'm going to put paint on top of this. I was thinking about two different colors, and I think I might go with that, but choosing the paint color is kind of pivotal at this point. And let's see if I can give you an example. Okay, so teal, as compared to, I'm trying to find a bottle that I have handprints all over, because all of my bottles have handprints. I don't want this color, I want magenta, but let's, anyway. So do you see those little black lines in there? This tells you kind of the opacity of the color. If you can see the black lines, meaning it's more transparent than any of the other color, like the teal, which is clearly more opaque. And on the back, there's a little rubric that'll tell you, like, this opacity is, or transparency is lower than this one, clearly. That's important when you're putting paint on top of the glass bead gel, at least in this case, because I want to see that texture, that glass bead gel coming through. So I'm trying to find my, here it is, Quinacridone Magenta. Okay, because you can see how absolutely covered up all of that is. And I was thinking, do I want Indian Yellow Hue? What color do I want with this? I don't know. Cobalt Blue? Maybe. I don't know. How about I just go Quinacridone Magenta for now? And maybe I'll do it on the bottom. And if I want to add another color into it, I will. Now, obviously, it's opaque here, but it should be that I can see the paper, the texture, the shimmery glass bead, and everything else through it. Now, I might be picking up some of that glass bead just because it's not wet. I mean, not dry. And then I'm going to go a step further to bring out this glass bead. I'm actually going to, using this to hold my book down, spray a little water on it, because that'll dilute the paint even more. Okay. I am thinking Indian Yellow Hue. Ooh, Quinacridone? Oh, maybe Quinacridone Nickel Azo Gold. Yeah, I like that. Which also, like I said, I can see the lines through there. It's not as transparent, I think, but it says it is. All right, so I'm going to just blend this into... I'm trying not to pick up the pink. I also have some water on my brush. I've watered it down. This color to me looks like painted rust. So cover this up. All right, what do I got here? I don't know what I have here. Oh, blended it too much, I think. I don't want this to blend so much, so I'm gonna pounce some of that back out. Oh, I kind of like that. Ew, I kind of like the white space in there. I like that. Let's do one over here. Oh, I like that. I like that. Oh, I do. Okay, now I can't stop. Let's get a little bit more over there. I like that. Now the poor backside. I always neglect the backside of my little inclusion there. So let me, a little bit more of that. Azo Gold. Let's get that. Oh, look, so wet. Ripped the corner off. Texture. That's actually good. Okay, I'm going to dry this. And then I'll come back and we'll put some layers on top. Again, I'm going to dry it with the hair dryer on a cool setting just because I know that the layers underneath my paint there, the modeling or the gel medium, I can't think and do things. I'm doing two things at once. This is why I can't. The layer of glass bead gel is not cured. It's still a little wet. So I'm going to use the hair dryer just so it doesn't make it cook from the outside in. Okay, bye. I don't know if you can see the really cool texture. I'm going to try to zoom in and just hopefully you can see how all the glass beads, and you almost need to like, you know, catch it on the light, but all the glass beads are in there. If you look really close, you can see they're all just clustered. I love that. I love that effect. So, yeah. Okay, now that I have that, no idea what I want to do now. So, yeah, what do we do? What do we do? Yeah, I'll be back. Thinking a word with these. I got these at the hardware store, believe it or not. Thinking a word. I know, like I need to buy more stickers because I'm trying to use up my stickers, right? I like these though. All right, so what word do I want? It's a good word for today. Honey, what's a good word for today? Make it clean because it's on the camera.
Gratitude.
Ooh, gratitude's a good word. I'm grateful that you gave me that word, dear. I gotta see, what's my center letter?
Oh, pencil.
So gratitude. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the middle one is the I. How do I want this to run? It's probably going to run across here. Maybe I'll just run it there. Let's see if I can get that to work. A little tag behind there because it obviously extended beyond there, but these stickers are on so much texture I'm going to need to make sure they stay, and I think I'm going to use my collage polish. I guess I am now, definitely. And I'm going to cover over them. Of course my brush is really skanky now, so I have to make sure I have all that off. This should hopefully seal them in place. Now I could use gel medium, but I'm thinking that there's so much gel medium on there now, I'm going to use the collage podge just because it's a little bit thinner. It should dry clear, so I'm hoping that it will. And it's really this eye that kind of wraps around here that I'm worried about. Hopefully I can get it to stay in place. Maybe I'll get a little extra collage podge on there. And yeah, maybe I can force it into sticker submission, and this one too, and then I'm gonna dry that again on a hair dryer with low setting because I know that my glass bead gel is not totally cured. All right, so now I'm thinking I'm gonna finger paint on the outside of this, and I know as crazy as it might seem, I'm thinking permanent violet dark. I've got my palette pad over here. I've been using, even though I love my palettes still, palette pads are just a little bit easier. I can reuse them to clean as much, just kind of resisting paper. I know, I'm going purple. It's kind of a magenta purple though. And I'm just gonna finger paint, kind of to blend some of this in. Now, what's cool is that I do have that collage podge, so the paint should not necessarily stick like it's not, like permanently. So I have a little kind of leeway to get a little grungy with it. All right, with the water I put on there, my letter stickers are coming off. So I think I'm gonna have to go to my gel medium because it's just stronger. I was hoping I wouldn't have to put it on there, but I really think, yeah, I put the water on there and the letters are just kind of coming off. So it's not even totally dry, but I'm going to have to load this up with, see, that's my eye. the one I was worried about wrapping around the corner. So I'm going to have to load this sucker up because I'm going to force it to stay. I'm hoping that works because I'm going to put another layer of purple on there. I really want that, see how it's dark in contrast? I want to have that faded one because I obviously sprayed it with water, but I also want to have that dark, rich, deep purple in there too. All of a sudden, I felt like maybe a pop of green, like I want to draw some kind of leafy thing over here. So this is really, if you could feel it, it feels really plastic. I'm thinking India ink. And I want to see like a leaf or a stem, some sort kind of coming up over here. Kind of like that just back there black, but I think I do want to add a little bit of color to it. I think I'm going to add some green gold and some gesso. So I'm going to make a little puddle of gesso over here. And then make a little puddle of green gold because I like to use it with some gesso. Maybe not fill in the whole thing. So I'm tapping my finger in some gesso, a little bit of green gold. Let's just see, let's just start on this one. Hopefully my India ink is dry. Maybe I cannot really fill in the whole thing. Maybe just, touch on the texture like that. Paint is not totally dry. I think I'm gonna go back over with India ink, but just a very little. Like I don't have it full. I just want to bring some of those lines back out because I did cover a lot of them, but I like that it's still pixelated. So just very lightly. There's hardly any ink coming off of my dropper here. I don't know if I'm done, but I'm thinking date stamp. And I think today is the 24th. If not, that's the date. Let me see if I have 24th. What is today's date? Today is the 24th. And I'm going to stamp it on the back of that tag. It's already there. Get my stays on. That works. And I think I'm going to put a little red, not red, the violet paint just around it. Actually, I should put a little adhesive underneath. New bottle of Helmar. Undo my protective seal. Because I only stuck it to the sticker. I didn't actually stick it to the back of the page. So now I'm going to take a little strings, little that right there. Because I haven't really done anything on the back of this inclusion. Not sure I love that, but it is what it is. Yeah, I kind of like that the way it is. I don't really want anything else. Unless maybe I did like a leaf here. Maybe like one. Do you think like one leaf maybe? It's rounded, so it might be more difficult. But I should put like maybe just the top of another leaf there. Let's try it. I was talking to you. Like, do you think maybe? Do you think that? That's crazy. And I look at the camera when I'm talking to you, which is even crazy. All right, let's see. I need to get this kind of as flat as possible. Maybe just do
was drawing this, I got an idea. I want to put enamel accents on here, which is just a crazy idea because it takes forever to dry, but I think I'm just going to do it. So I tried drawing them a little and I went back in with the India ink and I kind of just went over just like I did on this side. This is in no way, shape, or form dry, but I'm thinking it might be like midnight before it really does cure. The enamel accents, if you don't know what that is, it's made by Ranger and they're just like glossy. It looks like enamel. It's black and it's glossy. And it dries with a little 3D, so it's kind of like glossy puff paint in a sense. I really like it on there. It totally changes it, makes it really dimensional. I thought about putting it around here, but then I thought, well, that won't make the gratitude pop out as much as it does. I don't know if it shows up on camera, but because it's got a sheen to it and the ink has a matte to it, it really has a nice contrast. So I think color-wise, I'm done. Texture-wise, this right here, I probably need to zoom in because it's like my favorite part of this. See this right here? That whole thing, that makes me so happy, except for that little part. We should color him in with something. But that's the texture, and then this is the cardstock without anything on it. So it really does this really cool contrasting, picks up, absorbs the color more where the paper was without the gel medium, without the glass bead gel. It's just really cool. The texture, I'm going to try to take photos that really showcase the texture on this. I love it. All right, so I am going to be finished now for the day. I've got my date on the back of here, and that's it for Inspiration Wednesday. I have been taping from my computer, so let's just see how that turns out. Of course, I'm not wearing a bra, so let's see how that looks on camera. And hey, see you next week for Inspiration Wednesday. Peace out.
Satellite in my eyes, like a diamond in the sky. How I wonder, satellite strong from the moon. Satellite headlines read someone's secrets you've seen, eyes and ears have been. Satellite dish in my eye, tell me more, tell me more. Who's the king of your satellite castle? Winter's cold, spring racing. Thank you.
satellite in my eyes, like a diamond in the sky. How I wonder, satellites strung from the moon and the world your balloon, deep in time for the
you. matter what you say.